myself, Suresh Kumar, Assistant Professor in Department of Civil Engineering. In today's lecture, I'm going to explain about areas and volumes. How to calculate areas and how to calculate volumes. We are going to see in today's lecture. The objectives. Explain the basic concept of area and volume method. Define the usage of area and volume calculations. And describe the methods that have been used in areas and volume calculations. Introduction. Estimation of area and volume is a basic to most engineering schemes. If any engineering project, if you want to calculate, it will depend upon these areas and volumes only. The earthwork volumes must be established. Whatever the earthworks, if you see any engineering projects or civil engineering projects, it includes lot of earthwork calculations. If you want that to calculate that earthwork, that should be done by these areas and volumes only. To enable root alignment to be located, such lines and levels, that cutting and filling are balanced as far as practical. To enable the contract estimations of time and cost to be made for proposed work. To form the basis of payment for a work carried out. So, if in whatever the workers, they are working for this earthwork cutting or filling, that cost will be estimated only by this calculating areas and volumes. Based on that volume, amount of volume, the wages will be paid according to the, for one unit volume, they will be charged for some X amount. See, this area calculation, the rectangular areas closed by survey lines, one is one method, and another is irregular areas. If your body is irregular, if you think that your body is very irregular, that is, if I want to calculate that particular line or particular area, like this irregular area, if I want to calculate, that will be irregular area. Next, the rectangular areas, that is, we can find these mathematical equation or coordinating stations traverse. If in mechanical, if you want to calculate that areas by using planimeter, mechanically we have one instrument that is called planimeter. In our surveying lab also, we have this instrument. This instrument will be used for calculating the areas. See, mathematical equations. We know these all mathematical equations right from beginning of your 5th standard or 4th standard onwards. We know the triangle equation, we know the rectangular equation, that is rectangular formula, we know the trapezoidal formula, and according to that we need to know these formulas. Okay, so if you want to find the triangulation, root of S into S minus A minus S minus B minus into S minus C, or we can find where S equal to off into A into A plus B plus C, rectangular A into B, we know, and if you want to find the trapezoidal equation, off into AB into A into B into H will give you the trapezoidal area. By coordinating method also, we can solve these, we can calculate the volume of that particular area. It is a formula of into ni into ei minus 1 minus, like this we need to calculate north coordinate and e will be the east coordinate. if you want to find irregular areas. So these methods are very, very important. What I am going to discuss now, these methods are very, very important. Most of your engineering works, areas and volumes will be calculated only based on these three methods only. One is first mid-ordinate rule, Simpson rule, trapezoidal rule. These three rules will be applicable for finding the areas of irregular areas. We'll see one by one rule in this particular lecture. Trapezoidal rule. This rule assumes that the short length of boundary between the ordinates or straight lines, so that the area is divided into series of trapezoids. So whatever the area, if you have an irregular area, that irregular area will be divided into number of trapezoidals. That number of trapezoidals will be area will be calculated, and then we will get the total area. How to calculate the total area? By dividing the number of trapezoidals by, we can find by using this formula. That is, total area equal to the D. That D is the distance between the ordinates into F plus L. That is, first ordinate minus first ordinate plus last ordinate. First ordinate plus last ordinate by 2 plus other coordinates, other ordinates will gives you the value. See, this one is O1 will be the first ordinate. You see here, my O1 will be the first ordinate plus last ordinate is seventh ordinate. O1 plus O7 by 2 plus remaining ordinates are this one. 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6 are the remaining ordinates. That you can use this formula or this formula. Okay, that will be shown here. If you have more ordinates, O1 plus ON plus 2 into O3 plus, you can use this formula also for calculating. Okay, you can use this formula. Any one of the formula can be used for calculating the area by using trapezoidal rule. D is nothing but equal distance between two ordinates. So you are showing that this distance is nothing but D, and your first ordinate, last ordinate, O1 is the first offset and ON is the last offset of that particular field. See, we'll see one problem on this trapezoidal rule. See, here the values are given to you. For example, this is ordinate 1, this is ordinate 2, this is ordinate 3, and this is ordinate 4, and 5, like, and 6. Like this, ordinates are given to you. Your ordinates are given to you, that is 6 ordinates. The 6 ordinates will be given based on that. That is 5th ordinate and this is 6th ordinate. But the distance is same. For all your distance is same. That is 8 meters. That your D value is, whatever the D value, that is D value is 8 meters. You know the D value is 8 meters. And your ordinates, distance is O is 8, 0, 8, 16, 24 and 32, 40. And your offset, your first offset is 0 and here is 1.5. And your offset value is 1.5 and here is 2.2 at ordinate 3. The values are given here. These are the values. Ordinate, second ordinate, you are 1.5, third ordinate, 2.2, fourth ordinate, 2.2, and your fifth ordinate, 2.1, and your sixth ordinate is 1.1. based on this formula, A, if you want to find the area of this particular value, your formula is A equal to D by 2 into O1 plus O6. Your ordinates is, we know the formula, O1 plus ON. Sorry, ON is nothing but your last coordinate, that is 6. O1 plus O6 plus 2 into remaining ordinates, that is 2, 3, 4 and 5. This will give you the value. We know what is 8. This is the distance between the ordinates. That is your D value is 8. I am taking this 8 as 8 by 2 into your first ordinate value is 0. And your last ordinate value is 1.1 plus 2 into remaining ordinates. 1.5, 2.2, 2.0, 2.1. All together gives you your area. The total area is 66.8 meters square. So for this irregular boundary or irregular area, your total area is 66.88 meters square. By using this trapezoidal rule, we can solve this formula. Okay. Thank you. We will discuss next method in the next class. Thank you.